In my last video, I explained all the features of my new quick install crosscut fence for the big cast iron table saw and the reasoning behind building it. And if you want to learn more about what's up with that and the benefits that come with it, you should really check out that video. The link is in the description. Because in this video, I'm gonna lead you through the build process of this fence. I used 21mm birch plywood for this fence because of its good mechanical properties. It has lots of cross-laminated layers, which makes it extremely strong and dimensionally stable. And I found one piece that was almost the right size and cut the other one from this triangular shaped piece. The edge was a little bit rough because it had been on storage for quite a long time, so I cut that off as well. And now cutting them to length with my old crosscut fence. It doesn't have a scale on it, so I always have to measure and mark and line up the mark with the end of the fence. Now testing the fit to the aluminium extrusion. This is part of the cracked T-Trex system. I didn't have the right kind of T-bolt for this extrusion, so I just ground down some M6 carriage bolts at the belt grinder. They need to be about 11mm wide. And that worked perfectly well. Next, I drilled the holes for the T-bolts into what is gonna be the upright face of the fence. And I had to countersink those holes a little bit, because the square part of the carriage bolt T-bolts ends up a little bit proud of the extrusion. And now screwing the two pieces of plywood together. It seems at that moment I was a little bit unfocused. In order to make it look a little more finished, I rounded over those corners. I always use some can or jars for creating roundovers. This degreaser, however, seems to work especially well for me. And smoothing those roundovers out at the belt sander. The fence is pretty strong already. But in order to make it even stronger, I cut those blocks that will act as braces between the two main pieces and keep the face of the fence from leaning in either direction. And I screwed those in place from the front and from below. And I actually offset the screws from the middle so that they won't end up hitting each other. Next, I drilled the hole for the dog hole hold down mechanism. and I had already found myself some washers and wing nuts for those carriage bolt T-nuts. And then I used a plug that I made from one of the corner offcuts and some construction adhesive to patch that hole again, because it turned out to be at the wrong spot. So I re-drilled that hole in the right location and then stuck the fence to the table using a piece of 20mm steel shaft in order to locate where the other locking mechanism needed to go. And I just traced out that slot in the table from underneath. And there's already our little follower piece made from beech wood. And I marked where to drill that hole, hopefully at the right spot this time. To transfer that location to the other side, I drilled through using a small drill bit and then drilled out the hole to its final dimension from the other side. Next, I drilled the same size hole in the little piece of beech wood. And then, in order to fit it to a carriage bolt, I chiseled the entrance to the hole square. And there's gonna go our little brass locator pin. And after that hole was drilled, I rounded over the edges of the part and epoxied it to an M10 carriage bolt. I made the locator pin from a piece of brass rod and ground it to a point at the belt sander. And I also epoxied that into place. And now I can insert the carriage bolt from underneath, and then I pulled on it really hard so that the little brass point made an indentation in the wood, so I knew where to drill. And a quick test if everything lines up properly. And it does. And now I just had to make a handle for it. To make it easier to grip that handle, I added this wooden spacer. And now on with the other locking mechanism. First, I cut the steel shaft to its final length using the grinder. And I drilled an accordingly sized hole in this block of plywood. And then I drilled another hole in there for a shaft that the cam lever is gonna pivot on. But for some reason I didn't film that. Now I made the cam handle. I first drew a circle, and then I marked the spot a couple of millimeters above the center of the circle in order to make it press down when rotated. and a handle extension. And then I stuck all those pieces together, which I seemingly also didn't film. But that is very easy to imagine, and this is what it looks like now. I think I must have lost some footage there or something. This little additional block is there to keep the cam from rolling away. When you close it, it obviously always tries to pull away from the fence, and that little block is there to restrain it. In the end, I painted and varnished everything to make it look nice and keep it from accumulating dirt. And the absolutely last step was to add a self-adhesive scale. And the fence was done. What I also added, but didn't show in the video, is a copper sheet metal rub plate to keep the cam from digging in. The 90 degree stop is just a piece of plywood on a spring-loaded carriage bolt. So I've already been using it for a little while now. And what can I say? It's awesome. Does it come loose from vibrations? No?